And welcome back to Star Trek Final Unity. We are on Horst 3 looking for Dr. So-and-so who has gone missing. And yeah, there's really not much else to do in this area unless we start, like, messing with stuff.
I do not believe that will work. I do not believe that will work.
Yeah.
I do not believe that will work.
We cannot use things. So the only way to go is to the doorway, then. We've been given access to the preserve. And we could also visit Dr. Fun Horse whatever lab. Atol Tree Monkey. Oh. There's the lab. Not sure where the preserve is. Maybe down there.
This is Dr. Hoon Forsh's laboratory.
Right, Hoon Forsh's. Oh, we're gonna walk up. Okay. I don't know about this thing. We should all walk. I don't want him walking off to the monkey by himself. Atol Tree. Well, the constable's office is up that way.
I wonder if it's one of the preserve animals.
We have to get up that close just to... Well, that's pretty cool. Just to look at it. Alright, let's all go look at the thing.
It appears to be hungry.
Oh my. Well, we can give it fruit. Or it'll eat one of us, either one.
It appears to be in search of food.
It's not very good at searching, is it? Let's just all bunch up together underneath the monkey.
I think it wants to be fed.
No pressure or anything.
I once tried an atoll fruit. It's quite delicious, but it stains fabric. A fruit.
A fruit.
The atoll fruit is considered to be a Marassian delicacy.
Be careful. It could be poisonous.
Poisonous.
Nice tree.
Nice tree.
There's a biotope up ahead.
Oh, didn't see that. Biotope?
There is a biotope at the end of this path.
I don't know what that is. Nice tree.
This tree is magnificent.
I don't know why I have to keep walking over the things.
This tree could house a medical facility.
When we're done, yeah, I'm gonna feed the monkey.
The Marassians commonly inhabit atoll trees, extremely long-lived growths which can attain heights in excess of 600 meters.
Extremely. Seriously? Crossroads. I don't know if they keep walking all over the place. Just to look at stuff.
The Marassians commonly inhabit...
I've seen that already. Crossroads?
These are the crossroads of the preserve. The paths lead to different biotopes.
Is it like a biome for a planet or something?
It is a crossroads.
At least you have to walk over to tell me that.
These are the main crossroads. The main crossroads.
I see we're all in agreement.
This tree could house a medical facility. A biotope is up this path.
The path leads into a biotope.
Okay, everyone else has said anything about the biotope. Do we all look at the lab?
That is the doctor's laboratory.
That must be Dr. Hun Forsh's laboratory. That's a quaint laboratory.
Oh, it's quaint.
This is Dr. Hoon.
Alright,
we should search for Dr. Hoon Forsh's lab.
Yes, we're doing stuff. We're going to feed this monkey. It's gone. Okay. Not even a thank you. Alright, so let's go to Kynian Biotope. Oh. Oh, look at the faces. Skull.
Hmm. This terminal is inactive.
Anything to look at down here? Caverns?
The kiosk might have the information we need to guide the field units.
We're gonna guide field units?
The kiosk might have the information. The kiosk might.
Alright.
There's nothing unusual here.
No, just your average skull.
It looks like this computer terminal's power has been cut. The field units need the right coordinates to begin their search. This kiosk might have that information.
Hmm.
Intriguing.
Hmm.
This terminal is offline. The power grid in this area may be damaged. We do not know enough about the biotopes to accurately direct the field units. However, the biotope computer may contain the necessary information.
If we can get power to it.
It is a skull. Nice touch.
I knew Worf would approve.
This terminal is deactivated. Perhaps it is damaged. We must activate this computer kiosk.
Okay. Oh, I forgot to talk in the previous screen.
I'd like to see what Dr. Hyun Forsch was doing in her lab before she disappeared. I'd like to learn more. Oh. I'd like to learn more about the doctor's research. Let's take a look at her lab.
I'm like, why is Crusher speaking?
The doctor's disappearance may be related to her research. Perhaps we should examine her laboratory. The doctor's disappearance.
We should search for Dr. Hoonforce's lab.
Okay, can we use this thing? Data.
I do not believe that will work.
Use skull.
I do not believe that will work.
Oh, it's a power port.
This port can accommodate an external power source to run the kiosk.
Maybe we can use a tricorder for that.
This port can accommodate an external power source.
I just like to hear everyone say everything.
There's an auxiliary power port here. It should accommodate a standard microgenerator.
A microgenerator?
This kiosk has an auxiliary power port. All we need is a standard microgenerator to bring it back online.
Tricorder?
This port can accommodate an external power source to run the kiosk.
Yeah, I wanted to use a tricorder, but I guess that's not something we can do.
I do not believe that will work.
Use the caverns. Is there anything else we can look at here? Any other part of the machine? Let me just move everyone over a little bit. That's pretty much it.
The doctor's disappearance may be related to her research.
It's not working.
Skull's not working.
I do not believe that will work.
That does not work.
That's not working.
All right, let's go. See if we can find a power source. I could just walk to the laboratory. What if we talk from here?
That won't work.
I'm trying to talk to you, Crusher.
I'd like to learn more about the doctor's research. Let's take a look at her lab.
The doctor's disappearance may be.
We should search.
Yeah, they're saying the same stuff, actually.
I'd like to see what Dr. Hyun for.
Oh, that was moving. Look at Constable's office.
That's the Constable's office.
Huh. Some office.
Constable Lixie's office is accessible by path or branch. Walking would be easier than brachiation.
Hello? Did you see that? I didn't have time to react to that.
It is an excellent vantage point for overseeing the preserve.
The constable has a wonderful view of the preserve.
Alright, we should get to the laboratory before something horrible happens to us. We'll just save. Having a great game with this guy. It's a great time with this game, rather. Let's walk to the laboratory. Very slowly. And inexorably. I guess we go through that hole and then come out the other side. And we get to watch her go all the way. Luckily, I don't have to have everyone move. I will join up. Eventually. Yeah. Okay. Stuff. Is that dead? Yes, it's a carcass.
There must be something unusual about these carcasses, or the doctor would not have kept them. I recommend full biological and sonic scans.
Sonic scans?
Dr. Hundforsch was examining these carcasses for a reason. I suggest we perform biological and sonic scans on the carcasses ourselves.
The doctor was only supposed to be cataloging species. What would she be doing with these carcasses?
Hopefully nothing nefarious.
I wonder what was so interesting about these carcasses. Let's get them on the bio table. I'd like to do a sonic scan.
Oh. Is that what we can do, a sonic scan with this? I was wondering if tricorders did that.
The sensor array conducts molecular and biospectral analysis and gives a holographic image of a specimen or scan. This lab has excellent equipment. It seems the Morassians gave Dr. Hundforsch all the technical support she needed. The sonic scope uses sound wave impulses to give detailed cellular analysis.
Like an advanced, like DNA sonogram or something? Oh, we're gonna walk over.
It's a cryogenically preserved specimen.
Bioprobe.
This bio table has a bioassay hardware to examine specimens and read scans.
Okay.
The bioprobe removes samples from field units which collect them from animals.
So where are the aliens and we're probing stuff? The different carcasses have different... Is it cryogenically? It looks like it just dropped there on this stuff. What do we see here? What? Carcass. Counter.
There's nothing unusual here.
Computer. Com port.
A computer.
Those dastardly things.
It's a communications port.
It says field unit C, D, A, okay.
Field units are built to suit different environments, so they can travel in zoological habitats and check on the animals.
Okay. So we sent these things by remote control, I guess, to check on them.
Field units are... The sensor array conducts molecular and biospectral analysis and gives a holographic image of a specimen or scan.
Okay. What's data have to say?
The overhead sensor array conducts molecular and biospectral analysis. It projects holographic images of a specimen or scan. It is a sonic scope. It uses acoustic resonances to analyze molecular structures. Dr. Hunforsch has maintained an excellent laboratory. All of her equipment is highly advanced.
Amazing how we're so impressed when we just look at piping.
The biotable incorporates bioassay hardware to analyze specimens and perform scans.
Yep. And this thingy?
The bioprobe analyzes samples that a field unit collects from specimens. It is used primarily for zoological analysis.
Alright, computer.
The computer is a Birkin 400K model from Arguello 9. The system is accessed by voice print or password.
A Birkenstock 400K,
The field unit is configured for a specific terrain and climate. It monitors the conditions of animals who have been injected with identification microchips.
Right.
This paramammalian species has been cryogenically preserved for medical analysis.
Same thing here?
It is possible that this animal is an Akana boar from the planet Jervis.
You said something different there. Counter?
Intriguing.
It's an intriguing counter. Never before has a counter been so counter-like.
It is a sensor array. It displays holographic X-ray images. This laboratory seems well equipped. We did not come here for
sightseeing. Come on down.
The doctor must use this to examine her animals. It is a zoological tool of some kind.
Got to have data look at the comm port.
This port allows a tricorder to access the computer and communications systems.
Cool.
Security protocol is not required to establish a comm link.
Good, because we have tricorders. It is dead.
It is dead.
I think I know Worf too well now.
It is dead. We did not come here for sightseeing.
It's a computer.
It is a computer. It looks like a microscope.
Yeah, he doesn't know much about this stuff. Neither do I, Worf, so don't feel bad.
This port provides tricorder access to computer and communication systems.
Alright. Deanna Troi.
This sensor array looks similar to the ones in sickbay. Dr. Hunforsch must examine animals with it.
She must.
Dr. Hunforsch certainly has a well-equipped laboratory.
Just look at those pipes. They're amazing.
It looks like some kind of microscope.
Here she comes.
The doctor probably uses this to examine her animals.
Bioprobe.
It's a bioprobe. It's used to extract biological samples from the field units. It's a field unit.
It's a field unit.
It's a carcass.
So descriptive.
It's a carcass.
It's a carcass.
It's a computer.
Did I look at this thing?
It looks like some kind.
Yeah, it did.
This port provides tricorder access.
Oh, these things.
The field unit is configured for a specific terrain and climate. It monitors the conditions of animals who have been injected with identification microchips.
I think he did look at it. I forgot to have Worf look at it.
It is a field unit.
Well, we squeezed 5 more words out of Worf. Well.
I wonder what was so interesting about these carcasses.
Well, I did talk to them already. Do a sonic scan. I don't believe it's really cryogenically preserved. Subject is marked as a Frednorian boar. Possible cause of death is malnutrition. No one's talking anymore. Not speaking. Let's use the tricorder on it then, because we wanted to do that too. Or in medical. Now Crusher do that.
It's a cryogenically preserved specimen.
Well, at least we're talking again. Can we get the thing back then? Can we get this? How many carcasses are there? Okay. Put that on the
it's
table.
It's not working.
Use carcass on data. No. Bio table.
It's not working.
I can't put that.
It's not working.
Oh, she walked all the way over there. What about this one?
It's not working.
Not working. Only this one?
It's not working.
Not working anymore? Not. Okay.
Subject is marked as a Frednorian boar.
Now it talks.
Probable cause of death is malnutrition.
Okay, let's take this. Boar scan. Oh, let's look at the boar scan first.
This boar couldn't digest certain nutrients and therefore starved to death. Some kind of mineral not native to Marassia was lacking in its diet.
Hmm.
The boar starved to death due to its inability to digest some of the native Marassian nutrients. The boar's true identity can be resolved with a sonic scope test.
Right.
The boar starved to death due to the incompatible nutrients. A sonic scan will reveal its true identity.
It's really Peter Parker!
It's been a while since I took exobiology.
Nah. Alright, can we use bioprobe on it?
It's not working.
Not working?
It's not working.
Alright, let's not use bioprobe. Let's use the scope.
It's not working.
Okay, maybe we have to use our tricorder on this port. The doctor's files have been erased. I can make out one message from her personal log. Sessions with tracker Melas canceled. Schedule again after field trip. Oh wow, look at this. We talked to all these people. Let's talk to all of them. Grower Inongo.
Open a channel to Grower Inongo.
Channels to Grower Inongo are closed indefinitely.
Well, that voice. It sounds like gloating evil, doesn't it? Tracker Melas.
Open a channel to Tracker Melas.
Channels open.
I'm Dr. Beverly Crusher of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating Dr. Hunforsch's disappearance.
Greetings. I doubt that she is in any danger. She's probably just taking a vacation after her blow-up with Constable Lixie.
Taking a vacation, huh? Yeah, how do you know her? I found your name in Dr. Hunforsch's lab. How do you know her?
I teach her territorial recognition. At least I did. We suspended our lessons after the power outages began. I haven't seen her since, but I doubt she's lost. Such an excellent tracker, even if she is a bit weak in the nose.
Well, no one really cares at all, or they just assume she's fine for some reason. Yeah, power outages. You mentioned some mentioned some power outages. Could you tell me anything more about them?
A power surge at our quarantine shelter destroyed some of the generators. Two watchers were seriously injured and several animals escaped. Since then, we've had outages in the biotopes. They're still under investigation.
Right. I've seen one of them. Choosing all this?
The constable didn't say anything about that. I suppose that with the generator out, the individual containment fields in the shelter wouldn't work either. You wouldn't be able to hold anything there.
That's right. Most of our personnel are out searching for escaped animals right now. Dr. Hunforsch might be doing that on her own.
Yeah, I have to shut this thing off. Ask her about the carcasses?
I'd like to ask you about some animal carcasses we found in the doctor's lab.
Of course.
Yeah, ask her about the boar.
A boar seems to have died of starvation. How could something that preventable happen here?
Hard to say. The watchers are quite good. I can't imagine they'd just let this happen. Maybe they were given the wrong care instructions. Or maybe the animal was not identified correctly.
You've been very helpful. Thank you for your time.
I wish you well on your search.
It's possible the constable felt that telling us about her argument with the doctor would arouse our suspicions. But why would she withhold information about the escapes?
Dunno. But let's... grab this thing back. Thank you. So we can continue talking to them without this annoying sound.
Open a channel to Tracker Malus.
Channels open.
One question we didn't ask. Have you contacted the doctor recently?
Have you contacted Dr. Hunforsch recently?
No, I still have no scent of her. But I feel she will return soon enough.
These carcasses were in Dr. Hunforsch's laboratory. Can you explain their significance?
Show me what you have, Lieutenant.
However, I must run some tests first. Thank you for your time.
Okay, so after we run some tests, we can...
You're most welcome.
Talk to her about that. I'm gonna avoid that other question then, because we might need her for some answers and such. I think it's better to use the females to speak. Consultant Idia.
Open a channel to Consultant Idia.
Channels to Consultant Idia are closed at this time.
Of course, and supposedly the Consultant Idia was the last one to see the doctor. Healer Zolas.
Open a channel to Healer Zolas.
Channels to Healer Zolas.
Closed. Tiller Mivet.
Open a channel to Tiller Mivet.
Channels to Tiller Mivet are closed indefinitely.
Indefinitely. Damn it. Alright, can we do tests? Use carcass put here?
Serial diagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete. All readings are normal.
Huh. We don't have to use this thing?
It's not working. It's a cryogenically preserved specimen.
Well, we got no answers from it. Oh, we can't talk to herself. Speak.
The doctor was only supposed to be cataloging the species. What would she be doing with these carcasses?
Alright, I don't know. So, can we use this?
I see no way of using this with that object.
Can't bioprobe it? It seems like a thing you'd do.
I see no way of using this with that object.
Oh, we can't put it down on the counter?
There must be something unusual about these carcasses, or the doctor would not have kept them.
Yeah. Alright, so let's grab this one. I don't even know which... It's that one, right? That we have? Let's put this one here.
Seriodiagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete. Subject's genetic signature differs from its identification tag.
Ah.
Subject is in a carnivore.
Quick! Dance! anything to say, Doctor?
The doctor was only supposed...
No.
I wonder what was so interesting about...
Well, we are scanning them. They don't really seem to have anything. Alright, not sure if we did this one or this one.
I see no way of you...
Yeah, you do.
Seriodiagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete.
Huh.
Subject's neural pathways have been drained of electrical energy.
Damn. Dance!
Dr. Beverly Crusher.
Oh, I wanted you to talk to her.
The doctor was only sub-
Okay, I don't know. I don't know.
That is unnecessary.
Crusher. Do we have all the stuff we needed yet? Tracker Melas again?
Open a channel to Tracker Melas.
Channels open.
I'd like to ask you about some animal carcasses we found in the doctor's lab.
Of course.
Yes, the creature's tagged as a Fredonian boar. Abandoned Federation space. Interesting.
This creature is tagged as a Fredonian boar. But tests show it's an carnivore, which is banned in Federation space. How did it get to Marassia?
That's one of the new arrivals from the second shipment. Maybe there was an error. You know, we've had a number of minor problems with creatures from that shipment.
Really?
You've been very helpful. Thank you for your time.
I wish you well on your search.
Just want to try something.
It's not working.
I hope it worked.
Open a channel to...
Channels open.
Right, so the constable and the doctor had an argument.
So the constable and Dr. Hunforsch had an argument.
Dr. Hunforsch discovered that several animals from Aramut's second shipment were illegal species which had been mistagged. I think she accused the constable of smuggling, but I'm not sure. Healer Zolas told me the story.
Hmm. So, secondhand information at best. Let's ask her this about the Watchers first.
What exactly do the Watchers do?
The Watchers feed and care for the preserved species.
Okay. Yeah, if accusations of smuggling were confirmed, etc.
If the accusations of smuggling were confirmed, it would seriously jeopardize Marassia's chances for membership in the Federation.
That's why she thought Constable Lixie might be involved, to thwart Federation entry.
Hmm. Well, you've been very helpful.
You've been very helpful. Thank you for your time.
I wish you well on your search.
Okay, guys, that'll be it for this episode. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see what we figure out next time. And endure. And enduring, grow strong.